Pretty vibes only.
Easy.
Miss T on the beat, let's go.
It's
Carlo on the beat.
Baby girl, you love me, I feel too carry. Love the way you love me, the way you love me. Then you make me wanna marry, you wanna marry. I'ma be your one and only, your one and only. For my dollar for you, yeah for you. What's in a go do without you? Yeah, yeah. Crazy, crazy, crazy my matter. Crazy, crazy, crazy my matter. Do you really need me? Do you want me? Do you need me? Do you love me? Man. I know I'm in popular demand. Only you can have my ultimate. I want you on the night. Cause of you, I'm a better man.
Love that they gave us like the summer song for December. We are set, we are ready to go. I'm talking about Yeezer as well as Miss Gideon. Pretty Vibes, I'm sure you've heard the song every single way, and rightfully so, guys, because it is a vibe. Yeezer is joining me to talk about the video and also just on the success of Pretty Vibes. Welcome to the show, Yeezer.
Hi guys.
How are you doing?
Back again, you know, your boy Yeezer in the building.
Superstar. Dude, like your audio alone has almost like a million views.
Yeah, do you know that? Yeah.
How do you feel?
I feel ecstatic, man. Like, you guys saw me, man. I was here two years ago,
started your music career
The first song probably had like 1,000, 1K, just 1K.
Why Not Records is the one, guys. It's the one.
It was dominant, but it just shows, like, you know, hard work and like focus, you know, and just discipline in your craft, you know. It takes you far, really, like, and it's not even a joke. And believing in yourself takes you really far.
I know people like say this all the time. Like, what are some of the things that you have to have discipline on?
Just you as a person, you know, the things you do daily, like the times you sleep, your prayer time. You have to be really specific with a lot of things you do, and even going out. Mm. You can't be out here in the streets like all the other people. You have to respect your brand, you know. Yeah, so there's a lot of stuff to go through, you know, but like you learn that in the journey.
No, I had to ask you that because, you know, artists can just come through in front for the people on TV.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I mean? Like, we need to hear, like, actually, like, are you putting in the work? Are you actually, like, putting in sacrifices? Yeah. But we see it. We see your work. And we just saw this beautiful music video that you and Ms. Gideon just gave us. Yeah. Let's talk about, like, because the song was such a success. So when it came to conceptualizing the music video, what was going on with the team? What was going on in your mind? Talk to us a little bit.
There was a lot going on, you know, like it's stress. Let me not lie to you guys, it's stress all over, you know. Obviously, there's a lot of fans that have to go inside too. And, you know, as being unemployed in this industry, it's kind of hard to. But, you know, it's all about sacrifices, actually. Yeah. So you just have to sacrifice a lot of stuff and just find yourself, put your money in your art and then just do whatever you want to do. What your dream, your vision. Just invest in it, man.
So this was you guys' vision, because it's pretty vibes. You guys were like, you know what? We're going to put pink flowers. Exactly. We're going to make it like a pretty thing.
Exactly.
And like,
and the good thing is we have even guys singing.
I know. Right?
And saying, yes, I do. So it's like a song that brings everybody together. There's no...
Speaking of bringing people together, you and Ms. Gideon, let's talk about this collaboration. How did it come about? How did you meet Ms. Gideon? And why do you think she was like the right person, the right voice?
I know Ms. Gideon for a long time now, for over 5 years. So I always knew she could sing. She always knew I could sing, but we just never. So when I started, she encouraged me, and then I wanted her to start too because I know she has a beautiful voice.
Yeah.
And I was like, nah, man, like, let's try something. And then we did it together. So we wrote the song together.
Mm. Yeah. Wait, okay, I'm gonna ask you this off air, but like I wanna ask you this. you know what I wanna ask you? Okay, but listen, like. In terms of you and Ms. Gideon collaborating, like, what was it like working with her though? I just want to know personally. Are you guys, my producer is like in my ear, and because there was a rumor that you guys are having a fling. I just want to get that out of the way. I don't know how to ask the question, guys, because there was a chemistry in the video. Are you guys like a thing? I'm asking for a friend. It's for a friend.
I can answer that off of A.
Okay.
You know, I just wanna keep it professional for now.
Yeah.
But you know, I have a lot of love for her, you know.
Okay.
I care a lot about her, you know.
Aww.
Yeah, so
you can only stab
so
a well.
So
you
easy.
Can
when
only
you love
stab
somebody
a well.
Already, when you love somebody already, it's easy to work with them because you guys are on the same wave, you know.
Yeah. Listen, like, do you actually feel like pressure to create hit after hit? I mean, you gave us like, let me just ask you straight. Do you feel pressure to create hits?
Nah. It depends on like who you are, to be honest. Like,
yeah.
And what songs you want to drop. Because if you're in your own lane and if you're on your own journey, it's easy for you to do your own thing, you know?
Like, wait, when you like in studio, do you like make a song and say like, people won't vibe with this, or people are going to say like this, or are you just like your own creative self and say, you know what, I'm giving what me as an artist
wants
to offer.
I'm giving what I have to offer, yeah.
Yeah.
Because a lot of the times, a lot of people try to go for, you know, what the crowd wants and whatever. And that's where you kind of go wrong, because you stray off of what you really want to do, your art, your real art, what you are meant for. Because at the end of the day, like, your head is like your gold mine. So you have to keep searching, and it's your head that provides the hits.
Mm.
So you have to depend on yourself and believe in yourself only.
Okay. Yeah. Not to sound like an old cat or whatever, or like to put you on the spot. On the spot. Do you feel like you make Gen Z music?
Yeah. I make music for everybody.
Okay,
for everybody. For every generation. I know.
Uh-huh.
I've had a lot of moms actually this past month in Vernil. They see me and they're like, oh my God, is it you? And it's somebody's mom, so it's actually a good feeling.
Somebody's mom.
It's somebody's mom. And she, probably my mom's age too. And
that's
so amazing that she listens to, that elderly people like that listen to my music. And there's actually a white lady that, she had my song as her ringtone, a white old lady.
What?
So
you know you made it when that happens. When that happens, you know you made it in life.
Yeah, that was amazing. That was amazing. That was
Awesome. That's so cool, man. Yeah. We love to see your success. I feel like it was born and bred here on the What The One stage. We like to take credit for everything. Yeah. But listen, what are your December plans? What's happening? What's your gig guide looking like?
Just work and work, you know, if you know what I mean. Shows and shows. So, and catch me today at The Loft.
Yes, AKA
is going to be there. We're going to perform there with my brother DJ Castro. So you guys better come out today, please. Okay. And then tomorrow we're at the Independence Stadium.
Dope. Give us a little teaser. Can you just do it for us, like, you know, pretty vibe? I can't, you guys. I'm talking not a singer. Can you just do for us a little?
Like, you love me, I'll be too cardi. Love the way you love me, the way you love me. And you make me wanna marry, wanna marry. I'ma be your one and only. Oh, my dollar for you, yeah, for you. What's in I go do without you? Ooh. Yeah, crazy, my himata.
Ooh.
Crazy, my himata.
Guys, no auto-tune there, you know what I mean? Thank you so much for joining us, and all the best, man. You know, in your career. When you make your 10 million, remember us.
Yeah,
remember us.
Thank you, man.
You are still tuned into What's It One. We are catching up with your face, of course, premiering the latest music videos. And of course, just getting your Friday started as well. We have DJ Kenzo in the building, who is honestly killing it. Like, all his music, the set has been fire, right? The set has been fire of DJ Kenzo, guys. So stay tuned. Do not go anywhere. We still have so much more coming up for you. But for now, here is another music video.